The TJ Smith Show continues.
Insight and perspective you need to hear about the local issues that matter.
WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
So one of the things I often talk about on the show, of course, is the food desert idea. And, you know, some people will say food deserts aren't really a thing, and others say, you know, it really is still a thing. And, you know, granted, if you have the means, of course, you can get your food delivered and use those services to get food. If you don't have the means, that can become an additional cost because you don't have the means and ability to get to a supermarket that's in your local area. Well, I bring that up because in Mount Vernon, another food market is closing, and it's been a staple in the community for a number of years, 24 years, as a matter of fact. That's Eddie's of Mount Vernon. They've announced they were closing. And, you know, kind of a big deal because you look at some of these communities with this density, and, you know, you want to build some dense communities and have a lot of residents. And one of the things I've been talking about is rebuilding the downtown Baltimore and here's the word, reimagining it from the center city hub of businesses to potentially more of a residential type space. One of the complaints or one of the things that's brought up often is about having grocery stores, just a place to go shop and grab some stuff. And the lack of that being there is something that is a bit of a deterrent for some people to move there. So now in Mount Vernon, you're going to have another hole of a grocery store option in that greater Mount Vernon community. Now, I was seeing on social media some people were really, really upset about this closure and upset really with the changes that they're seeing in the Mount Vernon community in all. Now, the restaurant business is a tough business. So to see those changes take place is not completely shocking, but they've complained about that. But these are people who are making a lot of noise and people who take a different approach politically and towards people of influence or what have you to have something like this replaced. But is this a concern, a bigger concern for the community? One of the things that we've seen with the suburbs more so is when a supermarket closes, there seems to be one right on deck to announce its opening. Now, you look at the northwestern portion of Baltimore County, and there have been some complaints about some of the supermarkets that have closed out there, and can they get additional ones back? That's a different story. But in large part, there have been others that have gone in place. Here, this is going to be, you know, again, a bit of a problem moving forward for people who live in this greater Mount Vernon area because they're now closing. Apparently, back in 2019, they had announced plans to relocate. They're on Eager Street right now, West Eager Street right now, and they were going to move to the Belvedere condominium tower a block away. We all know where the Belvedere is right there. I believe that's Chase Street. But they apparently didn't happen. And I would, you know, we don't know why that didn't happen. But if that's all played a role into their ultimate demise, we're talking about a dense area that they're starting to see a lot more vacant storefronts. And is that indicative of the continued problems, the growth problems that we're having? And this kind of ties in to the entirety of the conversation that we've been having this morning about we have to start sounding the alarm because it's things like this that can drive people away, things like this that can have people say, I don't want to move here. I want to be closer to where I can, you know, run out and take a bike or a scooter or what have you or walk to get to the supermarket versus now I'm going to have to drive to get somewhere to get my groceries because now there's nothing within the greater Mount Vernon area. So this, you know, and I see a text message. There are food deserts because the surrounding community robs and steals from them, and they're forced to close. I hear what you're saying, Texter, and we some of those issues need to be addressed. But now there are food deserts in places that might not be, you know, the reason for this closure. No one has said it's because of theft. It's because of the losses they're having from internal problems or what have you. It could just simply be a changing demographic. It could be just a business decision. But the fact that you have so few options as it is, it just expands that area that becomes more of a food desert. I'm not sitting here suggesting that issue of theft doesn't get dealt with. Of course it has to get dealt with. However, I think we have to look at it from the global perspective of what offerings are we going to have here? And you don't see this in the suburbs as much. And some of these line right at the city county line, supermarkets, they're not closing at a rate that you see some of the city stores closing that arguably might have the same problem. The same issue could exist. So you have to see. I don't think you can just blame it specifically on theft. Texter brings up Lidl. They bought out Buy Right on Bel Air Road. The building has been built for a while and didn't open. Not even a name on it. Now we don't have a market close. So, again, yes, that issue seems to be an issue that continuously puts itself in the forefront, and it's not unusual. Lidl is the mini market type places that have its issues. And looks like I have the owner of Eddie's here, Dennis, on the line from Bel Air. Dennis, good morning, and thanks for calling in. You're on WBAL.
Morning, TJ. How are you today?
I'm well, thank you, sir.
Good. Sad day for us.
Yeah, sorry to hear.
It's a bunch of different things.
Mm-hmm.
The COVID impacts that have accumulated a bunch of issues. Before COVID, the parking lot behind the stores were completely packed. You couldn't get on the parking lot. Now they're 60% empty, and that is, you know, the workforce that was a big part of our audience. So that hurts. Inflation has just been incredible.
Mm.
Staffing issues, I don't have to tell you about that.
Right.
And that's been chronic shoplifting and the violence that goes along with it. So it's accumulation of a lot of different things. We hate to do it. Our family's been doing this for 24 years here. I've been in the grocery business in Baltimore City for 55.
Wow.
And it's a sad day. We hate to see it go.
Wow. Well, we hate to see it go. And, hey, we thank you for your service to the community for 24 years, because we know you stuck it out through some tough times over the years. So thank you very much for shedding some light on it for us, Dennis. Appreciate you, man. And good luck in the future.
Okay.
Good luck to all your employees. Thank you. All right. So that was you heard it from Dennis himself. So a combination of things, as we suspected, a combination of things has driven out yet another supermarket. And again, we have to become a bit more business friendly, because you heard the phone ringing in the background. Dennis is not rich lying up on a boat right now. He's at work. Again, the mentality behind some of our more progressive politicians are, you're an entrepreneur, that means you're rich. We have to look out for the little entrepreneurs, the small business owners. They need our help, too. This is the TJ Smith Show here on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.